Welcome to Understand the Math. Today I'm going to teach you all about how to find the domain of a function. I'll walk you through five example problems, starting with some basic ones and working up to some more complicated ones. By the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to find the domain of any function you'll encounter. Be sure to check out the link below for free guided notes that you can use while you watch this video. There's space in the notes for you to highlight the concepts that we'll go over and fill out the answers to the examples that we're going to do. You'll also then have a set of notes to refer back to when you need to review this concept again or study for a quiz or an exam. Let's begin by talking about what the domain of a function is and how to find it. A function describes the dependence of one quantity on another. The output depends on the input. The domain is then just the set of all possible input values for which the function is defined. It includes all the values that you can plug into the function without causing any mathematical issues, such as division by zero or taking the square root of a negative number. There are two steps that you need to complete to find the domain of a function. The first one is the hardest one, and it's to determine what values will not be included in the domain. And then after those are determined, what you need to do next is just write down the values that are included. Let's now walk through our five example problems. Our first example has two functions. The first one is a linear function, and the second one is a quadratic function. Both of these functions are polynomial functions. I've graphed both of these functions so that we can understand the domain better. All real numbers x can be inputs into these functions. So the domain can be written in interval notation as minus infinity to infinity. This means that all real values x from minus infinity to infinity are in the domain. Our second example is f of x is equal to 1 divided by x minus 2, and this is an example of a rational function. With rational functions, we need to exclude values where the denominator is going to equal 0, because this is where the function is undefined. To find the domain, we'll write down that x minus 2 cannot be equal to 0. This tells us that x cannot be equal to 2. Let's draw the number line, and we'll put x is equal to 2 on our line. This number is not included, so our interval cannot include 2. We can then write our answer as minus infinity to 2 union 2 to infinity, and we'll highlight that answer. If you need a review on interval notation, check out the video I have linked above. Our third example is f of x is equal to the square root of x plus 1. This is an example of a radical function. With radical functions, we need to make sure that if the root is an even integer, such as a square root or a fourth root, we need to make sure that whatever is inside the root is greater than or equal to 0, because we can't take the square root or the fourth root of a negative number. Our restriction is that x plus 1 has to be greater than or equal to 0. This means that x is going to be greater than or equal to negative 1. Let's draw a number line, and we'll put negative 1 on our number line. X is going to be greater than or equal to negative 1, so we'll put a bracket at negative 1 pointing to the right. We can then write our domain as all real numbers x from minus 1 to infinity. Our fourth example is f of x is equal to square root of x squared plus 2x minus 3. This is also a radical function, but it's more complicated than the one we just did in problem number 3, so I wanted to make sure and include it. We'll start with the restriction that x squared plus 2x minus 3 has to be greater than or equal to 0. Let's first look at when x squared plus 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. We can factor this We'll have an x and an x. We need two numbers to multiply to get minus 3 and add to get 2. So this is going to be a plus and that'll be a minus. So we end up with x is equal to 1 and x is equal to minus 3. Let's make a number line and we'll put these two numbers on it. We have a minus 3 and we have a 1. These values are going to be included in the domain because that's where the function is equal to 0, which is just fine.
We need to look at the quadratic x squared plus 2x minus 3 between these two numbers and see where it's positive. If we plug in minus 4, we can see that our quadratic is positive. If we were to plug in a 0, it's negative. And if we were to plug in a 2, we can see that it's positive.
So we're going to have to not include this region. We'll put a square bracket here and a square bracket here. And then we can write our domain as minus infinity to minus 3, where minus 3 is included, union 1 to infinity, and 1 is also included. Let's now tackle our last example. It's the most complicated one. It has a square root in the numerator, and it has a denominator that we have to make sure is not equal to 0. Let's look at the square root first. We have to make sure that x plus 4 is greater than or equal to 0. So that tells us that x has to be greater than or equal to minus 4. Next, we have to make sure that the denominator is not equal to 0. So we'll set x squared plus x minus 2 not equal to 0. We'll then factor the quadratic. We have an x, a not equal to 0. And then we need two numbers to add up to 1 and multiply to get negative 2. So we'll make this a plus and make that a minus. This gives us x minus 1 is not equal to 0, which is x is not equal to 1. And then we have x plus 2 is not equal to 0, which is x is not equal to minus 2. Let's now draw our number line. And the numbers that we're going to put on our number line are minus 4, 1, and minus 2. X can be greater than or equal to minus 4, so we'll put a square bracket pointing to the right at minus 4. Negative 2 and 1 are not included, so we'll put parentheses around those numbers. We'll have to write our final answer at the top. And our final answer is going to be minus 4 to minus 2, union, minus 2 to 1, union, 1 to infinity. I hope that you now feel more comfortable with knowing how to find the domain of a function and feel ready to try some of these problems on your own.
If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.